Hey guys, my name is Will Warren.
And my name is Mate. Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. This is the Rockwood Highwall A214HW. Highwall series, meaning that you're going to have taller cabinets. Highwall also meaning, or hard side, meaning that there's no canvas, even though this is a pop-up. So we're excited to show it to you. The A214HW. This is their high wall series for a hard side. That means you're going to have a little bit higher clearance for your countertops. You're going to feel a little bit more normal.
You're going to have a few more appliances inside.
You get a bigger fridge.
And it's not all that much more in weight, you guys. This thing only weighs 2,600 pounds dry, and it's 3,353 for gross weight.
Now, this does have a nice light on the front so that you can see what you're doing as far as being able to hook up and unhook when you're not, maybe you're going right after work and you're getting up there late in the evening. Two 20-pound propane tanks. You do have a spot for several batteries up here. I would say two is probably fairly typical if you're going to be doing a lot of dry camping. If you're going to be plugged in all the time, of course, one would work fine for something this size.
Now, the nice thing about this particular floor plan is you have all this storage right here. So we went ahead and popped up the front storage lid. So obviously, everything in here is safeguarded from the weather. And you can put these down to close it back up and latch it into place. Now, I should also mention there's sliding storage on each side. So, a matter of fact, Mate can show us how to slide that out really quick.
Yeah, so over here, there is a little latch that you pull up on, and then this can pull all the way out. Obviously, I can't pull it all the way out, but yeah, this is a great place to put like your fishing poles or something long, and being able to have this sliding storage makes it so it's a little bit more accessible.
Yeah, now you don't have to crawl in there trying to find the stuff that's in the middle of the storage. Instead, it can come out to you. Yeah. Now over here, obviously we have the passenger side of the camper. You have your grab handle, which is nice. This right here controls the lift on the roof, which we can get started here in just a sec.
Yep, I have the latch undone.
So when you're ready to set up, there's no manhandling the roof. Instead, you just press the extend button and it pops up like so.
These are the latches on both sides that we're undoing. So you want to undo that before you obviously start pushing it up. Now there is a handle for manually overriding that if you decide that you need that, or maybe your battery's dead or whatever.
Now you got storage on the back side over here that's underneath the bed, and it has the nice magnet holder too.
Yeah, so as you can see, those are the two propane tanks that come with the unit. You also get an outside grill that fits right here. This is the propane quick connect that connects right to the grill. And then you also get a small table that fits right next to the grill to put like your meats, veggies, whatever, to get stuff on and off the grill. You also have aluminum rims as opposed to like a white painted one. So those are gonna just look nicer, longer. Nitrogen filled tires, which are gonna handle better. The tread life is gonna last longer. And then you also have an outside speaker, which is kind of cool, with a Bluetooth stereo. So you can grab your smartphone and hook up to your stereo, be watching the campfire outside, and switch through your tunes.
And if there's radio in your area, you can use, that has a nice radio antenna. Just be aware that in order to adjust this, there's a screw to loosen. Otherwise, you're like me, and you'll just pop it off and break it. Now, we have also the nice aluminum steps, too. And over here, this is equipped with the bathroom, and this is the tank for that toilet. So this is what you can empty out after a camping trip if you decide to use that. Let's open this thing up the rest of the way so you guys can see the inside. So when you're setting up, you just release this door here and then come on in. And then what I'll do is I'll close this door behind me to make sure that this is in the right position when I lift this wall up. And that's literally all you have to do. Just lift the wall straight up into place. Mate, would you give that roof a little extra push? Thank you.
There you go.
All right, so that roof, or that wall is locked into place.
And then, once he gets both sides locked in place, that door will be able to lock. I'm going to go ahead and go over here and lock this.
Sometimes it's easier to get it from one side or the other.
Yeah.
Would you give that a little push?
Yeah.
There we go. Okay. And then this is the dormer. So this right here obviously would be a little cramped right now. And this is your bathroom area, which obviously we can't set up. So on the outside, there's a few latches. Right now, I can't push this open. But in just a sec, mate will release it. So now there's some gas struts holding up this roof, and if I push on this, it will just go into the right position. And then from here, I can fold up this wall, latch it into place. That's your battery box right there. And then this, same thing. And then to make it all nice and airtight, I can pull down on this strap and use this hook, just like the ones on the outside, to secure it. And now it's weather tight. Now this is your bathroom over here. This can be attached up here for like a little, there we go, for a little shower curtain track. And then the bathroom's actually extremely easy to set up. It's a three-part system. So this part first comes up, followed by this one, and they each can, there we go, latch into place. All right. And then there's a door piece. Oh, I don't have this one all the way there yet. There we go. Okay, now it's set. And our door is right behind us. What you're gonna look for is you're gonna look for this right here. This tells you this is the bottom. There's a couple of grooves for it to fit into at the base of the shower. So we're gonna gently bring this over, slide it into the grooves, and then these grommets right here will latch the door in place. And now your bathroom is set up. Now this right here is a combo bath. So it's what they call a wet bath in the industry. Toilet and shower are all in one. The shower water will flow out onto the ground or into a portable gray tank if you have it. And again, this toilet waste here flows into the cassette, which is what we showed earlier. Over here on the bed side, one, you'll notice that this bed does lift up and you do have access to some of your outside storage there. This is also where your AC slash heat pump heater is, in addition to your furnace. And then this mattress is actually a heated mattress, so you can plug in right here. Now this will only work if you're plugged in at a campsite or plugged into a generator, but you can set the temperature from 0 to 6, and that's super nice. I always like to throw either my blanket or my sleeping bag over the top of this, and that way it's warming up that bed while I'm waiting for it. While we're over here, you do have a microwave, which is kind of cool. And as you can see, this table dinette is set up. You do have storage underneath it, and this does fold into the bed. Now this table is just attached with one leg right here, and then it's attached to the wall, just so you know. And then over here, this is just a nice table to be able to put, like, you have a GFI protected outlet, and then you could throw your laptop or what have you right here. You also have up here a clothes hanger. That's what this is. And then these little latches here, this comes with a foldable wardrobe. So that just hangs right here if you decide to add that. Pleated shade if you want to get to see those stars out there at night. And then all of these windows roll up. So
That way you have real windows that you're looking at, or you can fold them down if you need some privacy. And then this opens, and this window opens as well.
Right. Now, directly above the dinette, you have your max air fan. So that right there will move about 820 cubic feet of air per minute on the highest setting. So it acts like a whole house fan in something like this. Oftentimes, you won't need to even run the AC. If you're here in Colorado, you're just going to probably turn that on, and it's going to cool down really well. Now, down on this section, I wanted to show you guys this. This is that table that Mate was talking about earlier for the outside by the grill for the prep space. That just hooks onto the wall. And then this right here is your fuse box and breakers. So if you have any kind of electrical go out, one of these will light up to tell you which one to replace. And then across from the bathroom is your kitchen area. And there's a couple of really nice features about this. This is your sink right here. Now, if you would accidentally forget to put this down and you were collapsing this, the way this is designed, this lid will come down and nothing will be broken on your sink. But here, just fold that up and you can get hot and cold water from that outlet. And there's still a little antifreeze in this. Rockwood does water pressure test all of their campers before they come to the dealership. That way they know that there are no leaks on board. This right here is your cooktop with built-in backsplash. So you got a two burner range and it has an auto igniter. So you don't have to bring a match or a lighter with you as well. This is that bigger fridge we were talking about. So this is a 4 cubic foot, a three-way fridge. This will run on propane, it'll run on AC, so shore power, and it'll run on DC, so it'll run on your battery. So something, a lot of times people will cool this down before they go camping. They'll change it over to DC, so it's pulling from the battery as they drive down to their destination. Then when they get there, they'll move it over to propane and they'll have cold food their entire trip. And to open it up, you just simply do that. So you got a few shelves here, and you have a little built-in freezer as well. And then there's also storage underneath here you can gain access to. And this is also equipped with a 5,000 gallon water filtration system that goes down to 0.9 microns. You guys, thanks for watching our video on the A214HW. We really love these hard-sided campers. They're great in Colorado. We think they'd be good just about anywhere. If you have any questions, please leave us a comment, or you can also email us at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. You can also give us a call at 970-313-4337.
Also, if you like us, you should hit the like button.
And if you like seeing these videos, consider subscribing to the channel. Our guy, Octavio, he is putting out content all the time, so there's always new videos.
All right. Thanks, guys.